All right, hey guys. So today I'm gonna be installing a new windscreen for my scrambler back here. The OEM one I liked a lot, but it had an issue with the bracket where the clutch cable went through. It would wear it raw and actually basically cut it in half. So I could have either gotten rid of that little connecting piece or just kept replacing the clutch cable. And I just said, let me try something new and see if I like it. So stay tuned and you guys can see what I went with.
Hello, Adventure Rider, DMC, intercom, mode.
Right here it is. We have got the unit garage windscreen and GPS support bracket. This is handmade. It's from Italy. It's got a little wind diffuser here, which looks like it'll help out pretty nice. The bracket looks very solid. This here is where the GPS would mount. I'm actually going to put my quad lock hook up there because I run with a phone instead of a GPS. And then the instructions look pretty easy. We're only taking off the headlight. And then this is a little decal kit. If you want to put here, it'll cover up the back of your speedometer, so it won't look so messy. It'll clean it up. Now, the way this is set up, this does not route the clutch cable through anything, so you won't have to worry about it cutting the clutch cable like you do with the OEM windscreen. So that should be a huge plus. And I won't have to worry about that mess anymore. So stay tuned, guys. I'm gonna get it set up and we'll see what it looks like when it's all done. So we're gonna be removing a bolt here and the bolt here, pulling this out. Now what I went ahead and did was, because this should be already set at the correct angle when they came in for the initial dealer setup, that I marked it with a Sharpie here, some tape and a Sharpie here, so this way the angle I can put back and I won't have to worry about, is it 45 degrees this way or that way? You know, it should be squared away without any real issues. So just a little quick, easy tip there. All right, so these are gonna be for your actual windscreen area here. It's got these little, I don't wanna call them washers, but it's pretty much what they are. They're gonna be for your caps here to make it a nice clean look. It'll go over them afterwards so it'll close up that screw, you won't see it. The internal section here for the bracket that connects up to your headlight will be these, and your bracket itself is just going to lay right in there. It's going to pick up the four points and you're going to put them through. Now the directions don't tell you Loctite, but you should probably put some Loctite on them. All right, so I'm using a quarter inch socket wrench here, and the actual bit is going to be a 4. Now what I'm doing is I'm taking my finger here, I'm going behind and I'm putting pressure on this, and then I'm moving, you can see that, up and down. It's very little increments because the headlight's in the way. If I were to drop the front fender, it would make my life a lot easier because then the headlight would get out of the way, but I don't want to do any extra more work. It's probably being more work in the long run, but anyways, so that's what I would recommend. If you have those tools, use them, and then if you want to do it the right way, take the fender off. It'll be a little easier, but yep, so that one's secured. I Loctited it. Now I'm going to go through and Loctite the rest and tighten them down. All right, they're all in, they're Loctited. One thing I would do differently is I would actually get some washers next time if I ever have to take this off again. They should have come with it, but they didn't. So I would recommend before you install this, you get 4 washers, because that'll be a little bit more of a secure fit. So now I'm gonna put the headlight back on and then go for the windscreen. All right, again, because I did the tape with the lines, it was real easy to put back on. On both sides, it's all nice and lined up, so it only took like 30 seconds. So that was a Good little pro tip there. All right, so now we're gonna take these grommets and they're going to go in these areas here. All right, so these were really hard to get in. So I went ahead and applied some WD-40 and then they just slipped right in. Now the last step is to put on the windscreen and then we're done. All right, guys, I got it all done. I got the snaps in place. I got the decal on. It covers up, like I said, the back speedometer. I think it looks really, really sharp. I don't know yet how it's gonna feel on the road, but it looks good. It's good quality. I would definitely rate this probably as a 3-beer installation. That being, because this was the hardest to put on. This decal sucked. You gotta use a water and soap combination with a special brush to get it on, or it'll screw it up. I did mess up in one little area, but you know, shit happens. And you gotta have a heat gun too to do it correctly. And coming around, this is where the GPS bracket would sit, but I'm gonna take my quad lock and install it there, so this way I'm looking directly at the screen, so I think that's gonna be pretty nice. But a little rider view right there. I think it looks pretty good. So thanks for watching, guys, and I will see you out on the road.